One of my favorite things to do with for loops is turn summations into for loops. Because if the summation is actually just like a for loop just waiting to be alive, it's amazing. So basically what's going on with the summation is it says, and you see these in math all the time, it'll say something, okay, for t goes from 1 to 5, I'm going to add these terms. And I guess if I was like a real mathematician person, I would have that in like a big parenthesis, but I didn't because I'm lazy. But I'll put it into one now just in case one of my math teachers is looking. So I'm gonna put that in there. Beautiful, okay. And so the idea is that I, as the mathematician, would say, okay, it's 5 times 1 plus 12 times the sine of 6, and then plus 5 times 2 plus 12 times the sine of 12 plus 5 times 3 plus 12 times the sine of whatever 6 times 3 is, 18, plus 5 times 4 plus 12 times the sine of 6 times 4 is 24, and then plus 5 times 5 plus 12 times the sine of 6 times 5 is 30. So basically, if I was a mathematician, I would just write that. I wouldn't even think twice about it, okay? But for some reason, when people get in front of programming, they're like, oh my goodness, I'm terrified, what am I gonna do? And there's no reason to be afraid, because really, all this is just a straight up for loop. We are just adding terms. So it's really, really amazing to be able to take something that's just like this and to convert it into a for loop. So what I have here is 5t plus 12 times the sine of 6t, and I'm writing this down so I have it. But I want you to see if you can pause the video and turn this into a for loop. And if you can do this with no problem, then that means you are set. One of the good things is anytime you do this, you can always work it out by hand, see what the answer is, and see if that's the same answer you get when you run the for loop. If you can't get the same answer by hand as you get with the for loop, then you don't get what's going on, okay? This is so important, because a lot of people will be like, well, I wrote the for loop and I got this magic answer, and I guess it must be right. No, don't do that. If you're not comfortable with for loops, if you've never done them before, then you really need to be doing these by hand off the side. Maybe not from 1 to 5. Maybe that's too many steps to do at once. Maybe just do from 1 to 3, and you see if you get the same answer, and then you can change the indices on your for loop to be 1 to 5. So I'd like you to pause the video if you haven't already. Go give this a shot. Now I'm going to assume that's happened. So I know that my for loop, it's t, is going from 1 to 5. And if you didn't use t, that's okay. I'm just using t because that's what my system did. Now, a lot of people come in here and they write 5t plus 12 times the sine of 6t. And they're like, and they just run it. And they get these values, but nothing happens. Because all they did was write exactly what the for loop said. But remember that every time I run through this, I want to be adding this to the current value that I have. So since I'm adding, I should think, well, I need to initialize. And since I'm adding, I probably want to initialize to 0. Okay, so I want to start with, I don't know what that is, but I'm going to start it off at 0. I don't know why I spelled it that way. I'll just go back to bug. Bug makes me happy and I can spell it. So I'm going to start bug off at 0. And every time I run through, I want to add the new term. So there I go. Well, except I suppressed it. Okay. So if I want to know, if it's really, really bothering you, I could call something new term. And the new term, so what I just wrote works perfectly and it's beautiful. So so I could say then I have the new term, and then bug is bug plus the new term. The only reason I might do this is every once in a while I might have like some kind of a case or a break, and we haven't talked about that, but we'll talk about it later. But if I get to a point where, if the new term is like bigger than 30, maybe I want to break, and I don't want to do this anymore, but that's not really what a summation would do in real life. So for a summation in real life, we would just literally add the new term. So see, this way you can kind of see how this grows over time, and you can scroll up and kind of play with that on your own and see what that comes out to be. But so you can either do it like that, or you can just say that, bug is equal to bug. Don't do them both at the same time, you'll get double your answer. So you could do that, or you could just set it up like that. It just kind of whatever makes the most sense to you. But definitely when you see a summation, your first sense should now be to think for loop.